Hey YouTube, Pickle Me 101. I don't know how well this will turn out, but I'm making myself a scribing tool so I can scribe some of my mortises that I'm going to be making for the joints of the shanty boat. I used my chisel yesterday to get my two pieces of wood together, and what I'm going to do today is I'm going to thread this piece, and using a thread repair kit, I'm gonna epoxy in a helicoil that will accept a 1/4 inch hex headed keyed screw like this. And that way I can tighten my stick up and I can make accurate scribe lines and follow those on my marks with my chisel and try to get the boards to fit as neatly as possible. So you have the proper size tap, and all you do is tap your wood like so. So what you do is tap your wood like so, and then after you mix up your epoxy, they have another little tool here in this kit. I used to use this kit for a lot of different things. One of the things I used it for was those portable dance floors where the pieces stuck together. They had aluminum edge going through a piece of oak. And anyway, you take your tool, you thread your helicoil in, and then they have another little tool in here, a punch, where you can break this little tang off and get it out of the way so you can put your threaded screw in there. So I'll shut this off, and when I get it all done, I'll come back and I'll show you what we made. Okay, here is the marking guide that I was building yesterday. It's assembled. You can see where I can adjust the depth. I've got options to mark from this side, or if I need a larger scribe, I have a furniture thread here. I hold a larger 1/4-20 bolt. I don't know how well this will show up, but you can see that screw that I have in there with a lock nut. That little screw is sharpened to a knife point. And so when I pull this down here to whatever I determine to be my half thickness, I just tighten my set screw just like this. Now I'd recommend if you're going to mark, when you're going to mark the end grain, that you sand the end of your block, but I'll show you what I'm talking about and give you an example. You rest this on your piece that you want to mark, your half depth. It'll basically give you a chisel line. So you can see this line lines up exactly with the end grain line. And if I rescribe the other side, you can see now the other side matches exactly the little mark on the end grain, which is a little harder to see because I didn't sand it. But if I was going to mark a piece, I would sand that end right there, and then I would saw down to just about that final chisel line on both sides, knock that out of there, and then cut it smooth with a chisel or a little block plane. Thanks for watching.